Hi people, Marino Ray from Bokeh again. In this video, as the header suggests, I'm going to discuss something brief, but something that is still important, okay? Something that you should definitely keep in mind as a magical practitioner, especially. That goals are different, especially magical goals. Simple example is that things of an immaterial nature, such as mental, physical strength, and just one's overall well-being, okay, in general, emotional stability, stuff like that, not so much emotional stability, but still, those kind of goals, you know, when usually, for example, you're a practitioner and you work with a spirit, or you work towards making yourself physically stronger, or mentally stronger, or both. Those kind of goals are more black and white in terms of its content or context. So at its core, those goals are the least prone or least likely to change. And that's what I'm getting down to. Because you can compare it to a boulder, or you can compare it to a rock. These are black and white things, okay? As the same thing as with immaterial objects. Have you ever heard of an immaterial object change value all of a sudden? For example, a 10-ounce boulder. Have you ever heard of a 10-ounce boulder all of a sudden changing after a while and it turning into an 8-ounce boulder? No. It stays in place. It's concrete. That's where the phrase concrete comes from. It's set in stone. That's why we can still use the metric system even a century or two centuries from now. Sure, it might become more refined, the same way that it was less refined centuries ago, but at its core, it's still the same thing. We can still use the same things, physics, mathematics, all of those same values still apply, and they'll always apply, God willing, of course. If God wills it differently, then naturally, obviously, it's going to change, needless to say. A kilometer will always be 1,000 meters. The simple concept of 2 + 2 = 4. It's set in place, it's concrete, it's set in stone, so to speak. 2 + 2 can equal 5 all of a sudden, or 6, or 22. 2 + 2 = 4, it will always equal 4, because it's always equaled 4. That's what I mean. These kind of things are set in stone. But there are other goals, okay, magical goals. Again, like I said, it's just in relation to the example that I gave just now. Before I continue, I just want to drive my point home in relation to some magical goals being concrete in that same context. So examples that I gave in the beginning of this video, being physically stronger or wanting to become physically stronger, your physical body, all of those things are the least prone to change. And I'm not talking about the least prone to change in terms of wanting to make that change. I'm talking about in terms of longevity, so in the long run. Once you've accomplished, let's just say you've practiced, you've underwent some magical project, and you said to yourself, hey, I'm going to work with Samael, for example, my beloved Lord Samael, for mental strength or physical strength. You want to become stronger mentally, or you want to become physically stronger. Physically stronger to the point where you've put on twice as much weight. Simple example. You're not going to lose that. Once you've attained that weight, you're not going to lose it just like that in a week or a month or a year even. Because you're pretty much set in place, provided that you continue working with Samael, okay? Or you come to some kind of arrangement with him to the point where maintenance is performed, as in to keep you at that level, at that weight, that physical weight. Then let's just say, for example, you weighed 100 pounds, and now you weigh 200 pounds. You're going to stay at that level. It's not all of a sudden going to drop. It's not prone to change. It's the least prone to change. So as long as you keep working with him, or you stick to your arrangement, or you don't even have to stick to arrangement, you simply follow his instructions, for example, eating and drinking well, and doing what you need to do, going to the gym regularly, then you're fine. You're going to remain at that weight. You're going to remain at your wanted and desired 200 pounds, so your 100 kilograms. But here it comes. There are other magical goals that are the exact opposite. For example, money. Anything relating to material wealth is fluctuant, okay? Even emotions are fluctuant. I can't come up with other examples at the moment, but that's fine. Money is enough of an example. And that's simply because the world itself, within the world, in a non-occult or non-magical context, all things that are equal material wealth are subject to change. Just think about it. The stock market, prices of practically everything in the world to which a material value can be slapped on. We're talking about the prices of goods and services, coffee, everything you can think of, precious metals, gold, silver, platinum. All of these constantly fluctuate. We're talking about near constantly or frequently. You can just check this, the stock market. Gold dropped maybe a couple of dollars in the past hour, and tomorrow if you wake up and check again, you'll see that it rose again by $2 or $5, you name it. My point is that regardless of how minor the change is, bottom line is that everything relating to, for example, material wealth is fluctuant, not just in the actual value of the item, also in other ways, such as the demand and supply for these items. Okay, coffee on the stock market will fluctuate because it all depends on the demand and the supply. It all depends on what producers, what manufacturers or what agriculturalists that create or cultivate coffee actually can deliver to the public and what the needs of the public are. If all of a sudden a good deal of people will have no need for coffee or their interest in actually using or consuming coffee drops, then by nature or naturally it's also going to have a chain reaction. Okay, there will be an excess from manufacturers, quote unquote coffee manufacturers, and as a result the price of coffee is going to drop drastically by $10 or $20 even, metaphorically speaking at least. So yeah, the same thing applies as well in a magical context. If you, for example, work towards money, your aim is money, you'll definitely notice that generally speaking it's subject to change. You can't just say, oh, okay, I'm going to work with a spirit, or I'm going to work with some technique, I'm going to do some ritual, and great, you know, I succeed, and the ritual or the spirit happened to get me a good, well-paying job, I make a good five-figure salary on a monthly basis. Just an example, and that's it. Nah, okay. Of course, maintenance is there, provided that you follow the instructions that the spirit gave you or the spirit directly sees to it that you stay at that level. Yeah, you'll keep making around the same money, but you'll notice that it's a lot more fluctuant to change. Okay, you can get reassigned or relocated to a different department, in a different state maybe altogether, or in a different country altogether, with a change in income. For example, a couple of thousand dollars less, a couple of thousand dollars more. This is just an example. For example, an increase or decrease of 10% to 20% in income. There might be good times, there might be bad times, you name it. It's the same thing, regardless of who you are or where, how you find, what position you find yourself in. Even if you're a seller, you're a vendor, doesn't matter whether you're a freelance vendor or you run your own company, you name it, it does not matter. You'll see that there are ups and lows, tides, high tides and low tides in terms of making money. There will be really fertile times when business will be booming, and other times things are going to be somewhat lackluster. And it doesn't matter how much effort you put into it, it will happen. Okay, it won't happen to the point where you'll go bankrupt, horribly bankrupt, but you'll notice that compared to your other magical goals, money is definitely more prone to change, and it makes sense based on everything that I explained just now. So yeah, this is simply food for thought. This is something that you need to keep in mind, especially going out to my fellow practitioners. Keep in mind, okay? You also keep this in the back of your head at least. Understand that you also need to be aware of your magical goals and the nature of, and their nature, just plain their nature. Okay, some magical goals will be more black and white and therefore will be ridiculously consistent. You won't have to worry about anything. And about other magical goals, such as money, for example, or things that are a lot more prone to changing, okay, you'll have to always keep your eye on the ball, okay? Never become nonchalant, otherwise you're going to experience maybe a decrease or unwanted changes, you name it. Bottom line is that those goals are a lot more prone to change, modifications, and or fluctuations, or outright intermittency. So that's it. See you guys later. Bye.